in order to quantify this, most people, they're looking at the mobility ratio. This is telling us why you will see a very high water jet at the surface.
The mobility ratio is defined as the fluid mobility of either water or gas divided by the fluid mobility of oil. The ratio between them will give us an understanding of the amount of water or gas that will be produced in a reservoir compared to that of oil. Let's say we want to calculate the flow rate difference between the fluid of water in this high permeability zone and the fluid of oil in this low permeability zone. First, we have to define the water mobility, and we do that by dividing the permeability in the reservoir water zone with the viscosity of the water. Similarly, the oil mobility is defined as the permeability of an oil zone divided by the viscosity of the oil. Permeability is measured in the unit of millidarcy, and viscosity is measured in the unit of centipoise. Let's say that in this low permeability zone, we have 100 millidarcy, whereas in this high permeability zone, we have 500 millidarcy, a typical permeability difference in a reservoir. The water viscosity is 0.5 centipoise. And let's say for simplicity that the oil viscosity is 5 centipoise, a normal value for medium oil. If we calculate the fluid's individual mobilities, we see that the mobility ratio becomes 1,000 divided by 20, which is a factor of 50, meaning that in this example, the flow rate will be 50 times larger for the water than that of the oil. Now let's take a quick look at a mobility ratio example of gas to oil. We find, using a typical gas viscosity of 0.02 centipoise, how the gas flow rate can become 1250 times larger than the flow rate of the same medium oil, making it obvious why a water or gas breakthrough severely inhibits the oil production.